Yo, what is up, guys? SCJ here, back with another video, and today we're going to be talking about Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving. All right, so The Athletic, or the writer for The Athletic, Alex Schiffer, just released an article talking about KD and Kyrie and their duo and trying to figure out what the pairing might look like come next season. I know most of you probably aren't paying for The Athletic, and the only reason I have it is because of T-Mobile giving me a free year subscription of it, so I figured I'd talk about it today. So in the article, Schiffer accurately points out how we have no idea what kind of system Steve Nash will run or the way he'll coach, so you gotta go back and find any footage or sample size of the two guys on the court together that you can. Since All-Star games and exhibitions have small stakes, Schiffer says that you can't really draw any conclusions from footage there, so the article jumps into footage from the Rio Olympics in 2016, and what adds to that footage is that Nets center DeAndre Jordan is also included in that footage as well. So if you look at the footage I'm going to put up here, you're going to see there's just a trust and connection between Durant and Irving, and as Schiffer points out in the second clip I'm going to put up here, KD could have easily split defenders and attempted a layup, but instead he throws a pass over to Kyrie for a three. There's just a strong trust and strong connection between these two that you can see and notice from looking at the footage, and especially the clip I'll include of Kyrie's lob up to KD. What you're also going to see in this video is it's not just the trust or connection that's apparent from their passing to one another, but these guys are showing a trust and connection with one another when they're setting screens, acting as movers or blockers, and just doing whatever it takes to get the other guy an open look, and that with both guys' great shooting ability, it could be very dangerous for opposing defenses. You're also going to see a clip of great ball movement from Team USA showed off in Rio, which got KD an open three, and expect that to be something we see in the Nets offense next season, as like Schiffer points out, Nets interim coach this past season, Jacque Vaughn, emphasized ball movement in the bubble to help his guys get good looks, and of course the Nets went 5-3 in the seeding game, and Vaughn will be returning to the Nets as the Nets recently made Vaughn the highest paid assistant coach in the league, so he'll be on Steve Nash's coaching staff come next season. Now let's talk about their friendship and respect for one another. These two guys are very tight and always make comments where they stick up for one another or got each other's back, but most recently on JJ Redick's podcast, KD had some high praise for Kyrie. When talking on what he's most excited for when he plays with Irving next season, he said, just his IQ for the game. He could score from any angle on the floor. I think that will open it up for everybody on our team. When you got multiple guys who could score from all three levels, it makes your whole team better. I'm excited to see how we work off each other. We played Team USA and All-Star games, and I'm assuming that this is a typo and it's supposed to say that gave me a little glimpse, but that gave me a little glimpse of what can happen, but I'm looking forward to the full training camp and full season. So it seems like these guys are excited to play with each other and got a lot of respect for each other in their respective games, but they also have very similar personalities where they are very different from most other guys in the league, and I really think that'll be why they're very good together. I do think they'll need to adjust the group of guys surrounding them and add in some other players this offseason, as this team reminds me a lot of a more talented version of the 2018-19 Celtics, where you had a lot of offensive-minded guys who needed the ball in their hands to be the most effective. So possibly finding a way to add a nice forward like Serge Ibaka, or maybe trading for a great defensive guard like Jrue Holiday, since he's been a rumored target for the Nets, would be a perfect pair of pickups in my eyes. I don't know what kind of supporting cast the Nets will need around Durant and Irving, like I said. One thing we do know is that these guys already have a great connection on and off the court, and it's looking like they'll be a top three or top five duo come next season. So yeah, guys, that's going to be it for this quick little breakdown of the Durant and Irving pairing, and I want to know what you guys think about KD and Kyrie as a duo, and how good do you guys think the Nets will be come next season? Let me know down in the comment section below. But yeah, guys, if you like this video, then give it a like, and if you want to see more NBA content like this video or my others, hit that subscribe button and notification bell. But anyway, guys, I'm SCJ, and I am out. Peace.